So you want to know how you can achieve this build? You want to know how to build an Autumn Sims 4 house? Then keep on watching. Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. It's so nice to see you. Today's video is yet another Sims 4 building tutorial because I obviously love to build in the Sims 4 and I thought it would be a cool idea to share these ideas with you guys. If you enjoy this type of content, please make sure to subscribe, like, comment, hit that notification bell to be notified whenever I'm posting a new video because it really, really helps me a lot. Thank you so much and I appreciate you a whole lot. Now back to our video. So basically, we are just gonna build this large box on this lot. We are in Brindleton Bay, if I'm not mistaken, and now we're just gonna build two more boxes. We're gonna add this one over here and this one. So we built this box, right? We need a bump out to kind of make our house look much more, you know, interesting and much more out of the ordinary, I guess. But we're gonna make this front box a bit smaller and we are gonna build yet another box. I have to admit that we kind of have an asymmetrical, you know, build up until now, but now it's about time to add a patio area. Now we're gonna add one more bump out to make this whole build look much more interesting, if that makes any sense. I'm just literally playing around with shapes and I think you should do that too, because sometimes you just gotta have fun with, like, I don't know, experimenting different things, you know, and trying out new ideas. And so we are gonna build yet another bump out, box, however you want to call it, because obviously we want to give this whole house a shape, a specific shape, because we don't want it to be plain, if that makes any sense, and try to keep it balanced, if that makes any sense. So I'm just gonna build this patio area, I'm just gonna expand it a little bit, and now we're just gonna center our house. Now we're gonna add another tiny box, we're gonna make it smaller, and I think we should make this part smaller as well because it seems kind of odd. Okay, so I'm changing my mind once again. I just deleted that bump out and we are just gonna add this sort of bump out and we are gonna expand it a little bit and we are going to add yet another box just to give some shape to the house, if that makes any sense. We are now gonna handle the roofing, which is probably one of the most challenging parts, if you will, but for me it really, really became one of my favorite activities because at start obviously I wasn't great at roofing. So we are just gonna use this gable roof. We are just gonna, you know, expand it all the way. We are just gonna use the same gable roof. Make sure that you connect those two pieces of roofing because that's super important. And we are just gonna add yet another tiny gabled roof on that tiny bump out. And we are obviously gonna handle that overhang. We just need to shrink or to make the main roof smaller and then duplicate it and then, you know, just press shift and then drag that bit upwards, if that makes any sense. I oftentimes feel like I'm not doing a good job at explaining whatever I'm doing whenever I'm building, but hopefully this footage will help you understand what I'm talking about. Now we are just gonna handle this roof piece over here. We are using obviously the same gabled roof. We are just gonna duplicate it once again, and on those tiny bump outs, surprise surprise, we are going to use a gabled roof because why not. And so we are just gonna move that bump out a bit because it seems kind of odd. The positioning was kind of odd, I'm not gonna lie. So we are just gonna adjust it a bit. We're just gonna sort of center it, if you will. And now we are just gonna center this bump out as well. And we are just gonna apply or place a half gabled roof this time to do things differently a bit. So I was heavily inspired by a picture that I found on Pinterest yet again. Now I'm trying to build a bump out, but I realized that the specific photo didn't include a bump out. It was just incorporating that roof piece, if that makes any sense. And so we are going to get rid of that dormer in a while. You'll see me removing it. There we go. Now I'm experimenting with two roofs and I'm just realizing that it's not a good idea. And so we're gonna get rid of this tiny roof piece and we are going to center this roof. And so we kind of still get the same idea of a dormer, but it's a roof, you know what I'm saying? So it still gives a certain dimension to this whole build. So that's a pro tip, you guys. If you don't want to use dormers, you can definitely use a roof piece on your main roof, if that makes any sense. So what I'm trying to say, you guys, is to, you know, be more bold, be more courageous, and experiment with shapes, with roofs, and all that jazz. Now we are building a beautiful, beautiful chimney just to add some detail to the whole autumn house, autumn inspired house, however you want to call it. And so now we are about to pick the wallpaper. The first thing that came to my mind was to use a green wallpaper, because I never ever use a green wallpaper for my builds, especially that emerald, you know, darker green. And so I was pretty much aiming for this specific wallpaper, which ended up not being the ideal solution. And so we are just gonna change it up in a bit. You will see. We're gonna use this Realm of Magic brick, which is super, super cute. I really love it. And I've never used it before in this swatch. So, you know, sometimes it's fun to experiment with new things. Sometimes change is fun. You know what I'm saying? So we are obviously gonna apply this wallpaper to the whole house. And now we are gonna handle the accent walls. I really like this particular stone. It gives such a nice vibe to the whole house. But again, we are gonna end up changing it in a bit, because I just wanted to play around with some more wallpapers. And so we are just gonna use these get together wallpapers. And I think those are so, so, so detailed and so unique. And so I thought it would be a great idea to incorporate them in this build, you know? We are gonna leave that bump out the way it is. We are not gonna use that, you know, get together paneling, because sometimes it's fun to have more than two different wallpapers in a house. So I really, really enjoy mixing up different wallpapers. Of course, you gotta be careful, because you want the whole look of the house to be cohesive, if that makes any sense. So we are just gonna apply the same stone to our chimney. And now we are about to pick our texture, our roof texture. And I really, really love this one over here, which is kind of a reddish brown, actually. And I really, really enjoy it. I really think that it gives those, you know, autumnal vibes. So we're gonna keep it. We are gonna use a white trim as always. I rarely use a different trim. I mostly use like white colored trim. I don't know where that comes from, but you know, sometimes it's nice to stick with those, you know, standard things that you're used to do, or, you know, usual things that you're in a habit of doing. So yeah, that's what I'm doing right here. And now you'll see me experimenting with a gray brick, because why not? You can constantly try new things and see if those are your cup of tea. And if those aren't your cup of tea, you can always come back to your original idea. There's no harm in trying and experimenting different things. So I really, really hope, you guys, that you aren't afraid of change. You aren't afraid of trying out new things, because that's what makes building fun, you know? Trying out new things and basically thinking outside the box, because that's super important. You can definitely see me now, you know, changing our trim to a more brownish one, because I'm not quite sure if I want it to be this wooden sort of a cottage. But in the end, I just came back, you know, to my original idea. So now we are going to pick some windows, some appropriate windows for this specific autumn Sims 4 house. We are obviously gonna enable our BB.move objects cheat. In case you didn't know, this cheat allows you to place objects freely on your lot, which is super, super useful and comes in handy all the time. So you just gotta press Control Shift C to open your command bar, and then you just gotta type BB.move objects space on. You just gotta enter it, Control Shift C once again to close your command bar, and you are free to build. So obviously I couldn't help myself, and I ended up using those seasons windows, because those are the ones that fit best this house. So we are obviously gonna use that seasons door, those windows, which are super, super fun. And you can see right here that after placing those two tiny windows on that roof piece over there really reminds us of a dormer. So we're just gonna place a a couple of windows. We are just gonna place some windows next to our chimney because the side of our house looks kind of empty, so you can definitely place some windows next to your chimney. Now moving on to the back of the house, we are obviously gonna build a bump out. You can do a bigger bump out, you can do a smaller bump out. I personally opted for a medium-sized bump out followed by another tiny bump out because we definitely do wanna give our house that depth, that definition, that, you know, that complete look. And so we're just gonna duplicate those two roofs. We are gonna rotate that half gabled roof so that it faces the right way. And now we're just gonna do the same trick with our roofing. You can definitely see that we have an overhang over there, but it's definitely much more better than it was before. We are just gonna paint those bump outs, obviously, and we are just gonna, you know, use different wallpapers because we love to use various, you know, wallpapers, and we love diversity, we love, you know, changing up things. So we are just gonna build our backyard porch. Remember to save your game, that's a super super crucial step that you need to take. I just realized this whole time that tiny window had a different swatch, and so I made sure to change it up. Now we are just gonna place my all-time favorite columns, which are the get-together ones, and we are just gonna end up using the white ones. I really like experimenting new things, and so I finally convinced myself that the white columns are the best thing because we already have that white trim, and so it would be kind of odd to use a brown column. You can do whatever you want, obviously, but that's just my point of view. If you have a white roof trim, therefore your columns should be in the same color. That's just personal preference, but as I said before, you can obviously do whatever you want. And so we are going to make sure to apply those columns to each and every corner of our house. Now if you want to be that extra, I highly suggest using another roofing, which is gonna be above your front porch, if that makes any sense. So that's a nice thing to do if you are intending to, you know, use a fence or a column right at the entry. That's my pro tip for you guys. Just place a nice roof, you know, put some columns, and your build will look absolutely stunning. Now underneath our, you know, roof piece that we have above our front porch, we're just gonna build a foundation, and now we are able to apply an exterior trim to make it look much more complete, because otherwise those columns would have looked, you know, sort of odd without that exterior trim. Now we are just gonna add a spandrel to those columns to make this whole look much more cohesive, if you will. And so I ended up using the same, you know, get together spandrel, just to use get together all the way through, because we obviously have the columns from get together and the spandrel as well. We're just gonna deal with the back porch right now, and I'm just trying my best to pick, you know, an appropriate fence. And I unexpectedly ended up using this Strangerville fencing, which I have never used before. We are definitely making progress here, you guys. We are trying out new things, which is super super exciting, you know. Now we are just gonna do the same trick, meaning that we are gonna build a roof above our porch to make it look much more complete, you know. And so we are gonna connect that roof piece with our main roof, and we are gonna apply the same texture with the eyedropper, and now we are gonna apply the white trim. So isn't that beautiful? We can even build the same, you know, fake dormer, if you will, but it's obviously a roof piece, and so we can do that to make this whole build stand out. I think that's super super important, and we should make our builds beautiful. And so I'm just gonna place the same columns, those get together columns. I'm just gonna duplicate them, and you know, it's a different look. It's definitely a much more complete, cohesive look than what we had before, you know, which was nothing. It was a plain box, which we don't really want in our lives, you know. And so we're just gonna duplicate the same tiny seasons windows over there. We're just gonna do the same thing on the left bump out, and we are obviously gonna add some more windows because I feel like we really lack some windows, at least on some parts of the house. Some of them really look empty, and so we are gonna fill fill that empty space with those windows. We're gonna pick a nice flooring for our front and back porch. We are gonna center yet again our house, and we are gonna put the whole build on a foundation. Do not forget to paint your foundation. That's super important. Use a nice brick, wooden foundation, whatever you would like, but do not forget this step. Basically guarantees the final look of your house, and so that's super, super important. Do not forget about this step. Make sure to paint your foundation. And now we're just gonna apply some stairs. Well, that is my eternal problem. Like, I really want to use some white stairs because we obviously have those white columns, but the flooring isn't white, and so it looks kind of odd. So I don't know what I'm gonna end up using, those being some white stairs or some brown stairs, but I guess we shall see. So I ended up using some white stairs, obviously, because those go very well with our fencing and with our columns. So I don't care. We don't have, you know, matching wooden flooring. That's perfectly fine. You can even add some final touches to your house, and that can mean, you know, adding some, you know, small windows to some parts of your house. That's what I'm doing right now, just to make this whole build look much prettier and much more complete. And so yeah, I truly hope you find this video helpful, and I truly hope that by the end of this video you figured out the steps you need to take in order to build an autumnal house in The Sims 4. So I'm just gonna try to reiterate whatever I said. So if you want to build an autumn house in The Sims 4, you obviously are going to use some fitting wallpapers that could be, you know, either green or red, because those are the colors associated with autumn, like green, reds, you know, brownish colors, all that jazz. You need to opt for some really nice textures, roof textures. You can even use brown trims and columns, even though I did not do that because I really like white trims, but you can definitely do that. And you mostly need to have fun building. That's the most important thing, because if you're having fun, the results will be much more wonderful, because you are obviously using your creativity, you are obviously trying out new things, experimenting with different items, and so that's super, super important. I think you really need to have fun while building. So those are my pro tips for you guys. Use different sorts of bump outs, use different sorts of wallpapers, but make sure to have a cohesive look, because that's the most important thing. So hopefully you find this video helpful, as I said before, and if you did, please make sure to subscribe, like, comment, all that good jazz. Hit that notification bell to be notified whenever I'm posting a new video, because it really, really helps me a lot. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you a whole lot, and I'll see you next Friday at 2 PM Eastern Time / 7 PM UK time, as always, and I may upload on Tuesdays as well around the same hour. Have an awesome day, just like you. Bye guys.